thank you for being here. Okay. We appreciate you. I can feel your enthusiasm.
Yeah.
Sorry. Let it out.
Right.
I'm almost happy to be sitting down.
It's Comic-Con.
Breathe.
Exactly. I was rushing, and then I ran in here, and I saw, like, people dressed as avatars. I was like, it's not that bad.
Yeah.
It's not that bad. Then somebody was like, I like your cosplay. I was like, thank you.
Yeah. It's me.
Tell
yeah,
me what this like, is.
Right. Like, what am I talking about?
Right. Like, you have a title for this.
I am a giant following.
Oh.
That's
right. It happens.
You're fired, Bill.
Let's put that, anywhere.
I'm so fired.
Thank you.
The first one's always the hardest.
Yeah. Still on coffee.
All right.
Bill's like, no.
I know. No, I'm just trying to...
Everything's sorted out.
All right. Because I get out of the way once this all happens. Hi, my name is Bill Ostroff. I'm the creator of GeekFest Film Festivals. About 7 years ago, when GeekFest was brand new, I was at New York Comic Con doing an event, and they had a Women in Comics panel at New York Comic Con, which was all men. And I said to myself, this doesn't seem right. So I created a whole bunch of panels that are women only, and I get out of the way and I let them do whatever they want to do, because I'm a man and I shouldn't be doing anything here. So I just want to introduce you. All I do is send them 16,000 emails to get them here.
Yeah.
Then they do everything else. Anyway, so this will be about an hour long. We're in this room for the next 4 hours. We'll be doing screenings at 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock. But after they're done, you can go see them at booth 818, where they will all be doing signings, autographs, all that kind of fun stuff, selfies, whatever. But I'll let them introduce themselves and get on with the show, and I'll get out of your hair. Thank you.
Love you. Oh!
Thank you so much, Bill. Can we all give another round of applause for Bill? I know you're like, we just did that, lady, but honestly, taking the initiative and doing something such as this, giving a platform to some incredible women as a man and as a comic book fan, is so amazing. And I'm so delighted to be here for the GeekFest Women of Sci-Fi panel. I'm your moderator for today. My name is Ciera Foster. Some of you guys might know me as Livewire from Ninjak versus the Valiant Universe, directed by Bat in the Sun and produced by Valiant Digital. And today, it's a day. It's about to go down. So I'm actually going to let the ladies introduce themselves, but first I want to just introduce them by name. So let's give them some love. So starting in order of seating, let's give a warm welcome to Crystal Allen!
I don't have time.
I'm Gigi Edgley.
Is it me? Okay, I thought you were starting with Gigi. Anyway.
Oh,
sorry.
Well, this way.
It was not in the middle.
Okay.
I'm in the middle, so I was like, okay.
I guess you are in the middle. I'm so used to being by Janeshia that I was just like, this is the start, because I already know her. So, yes, let's give a warm welcome to Crystal Allen, everyone. Yay! Who I read off. Big Star Trek fan, by the way. All right, and next, let's give a huge welcome to Jolene Andersen.
I don't have sound effects, but I'm like, bah, 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 bah.
And now let's give a warm welcome to, is it?
Gigi Edgley.
Okay, Gigi Edgley.
It's a bit of a weird one. Sorry about that.
No worries.
I've got an Australian accent too, so it gets even more bizarre as the day goes.
Yeah, no, I'm just like, I'm going to let you say it. I don't want to make it weird. All right. And last but not least, let's give a big welcome to Janeshia Adams Ginyard. Wakanda forever. Eat Bombay. Thank you all so much for being here, for taking time out of your busy schedules. I'm so excited. Before we get into it, I'm going to allow you to introduce yourself a little bit so you can give an introduction of what you've done briefly. Yeah, also do that. So I'm actually going to start with Gigi. Please tell us a little bit about who you are and what you've done.
Hi, guys. My name's Gigi. I'm originally from Australia, but I've been here for about 20 years in beautiful Los Angeles, so thanks for having me.
Yes.
I played Ciera on Farscape, which is a Jim Henson show many moons ago.
Yay!
And then because I had that connection with them, they asked me to come back and host the Jim Henson Creature Shop Challenge, which was a reality show where the creature designers designed, fabricated, made the mechanisms, and then performed the creatures for Brian Henson and Kirk Thatcher and Beth Hathaway. So that was a lot of fun as well. I've done a lot of Australian work, which isn't sci-fi, and you've probably never seen it, so then I'll hand it to the other ladies. Thanks for having me.
Well, all right. Thank you, Gigi.
Thank you, Gigi.
You know, I feel like you'd be surprised what people can see, especially in this day and age. You can get your hands on anything. So my name's Jolene Andersen, and I've done a bunch of different stuff. I do a lot of video games. I've been Ada Wong in the RE2 remake. I was in the Marvel Avengers game, Life is Strange, Tomb Raider, as far as movies go, I was in Attack of the Unknown, Alien Specimen. I've got a couple other things under my belt. I do a lot of TV, usually playing bad guys. I'm not ashamed of that. It's a really great gig. I was on Marvel Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. I played a good guy. And that's about it. Yeah, that's me.
That's it. That's all, guys. That's it. That's all you get.
Thank you. I love that. It's exciting.
Hi, guys. Nice to see everybody today. Thanks for coming to our booth. I'm Crystal Allen, and I'll start with Star Trek, because that was one of my first jobs in L.A. I was on Star Trek Enterprise as the Green Girl. The Orion Slave Girl. It was really, really fun, that makeup. That was a lot. And then I went on to do some sci-fi stuff as well. I did the Anaconda sequels, Anaconda 3 and 4. Yeah, both of them, can you believe it? and now, you know, I'm doing a lot of Lifetime movies of the week, so that's where I stand at the moment. Play a serial killer. Oh. So.
Whoa. It's like progressively darker as the table goes on.
Yeah, that's awesome. Thank you so much.
You. All right, Janeshia, you're up.
Can I share the mic?
Tell them who you are.
Okay.
Tell them who you are. Okay, so hey, everybody. Thanks for being here. I know we already talked about that parking challenge. So moving on. I've been in a lot. I do stunts, acting, Emmy nominated. Woohoo! Thank you, HBO and Lovecraft Country. Yes! I've done True Blood. I play Officer Khan on Station 19, which is the Grey's Anatomy spinoff. Yes, yeah, Shonda Rhimes. But I recently, I'm playing Nomble, one of the Dora Milajes in Black Panther, Wakanda Forever. Yes, right over left. It's a continuation of my character from the first Black Panther, where I also was the Okoye stunt double. So I was flipping over, doubling Okoye, and then myself, and then did Avengers Endgame, Infinity War, and then in Falcon and the Winter Soldier, I made a very epic entrance when I threw that spear at Captain. And next thing you know, in the credits, I had a name called Nomble. So thank you. And it means beauty, so... Thank you. Thanks, Bill, for having me. Yay, GeekFest. And visit our booth, 818.
Listen, if y'all not at this booth, I'm on the panel, and I'm like, I'm at that booth. I'm listening like, oh, I'm about to be there. Like, I'm like, calm down. Like, relax. This is such an exciting panel. I've done a lot of Comic-Cons, but I have to say, being up here with you women is such a pleasure. And all of these credits and all the things you've done just speaks to a testament of your professionalism and just who you are as a person to have even accomplished those things. So I salute all of you. And without further ado, let's get into it. Are you guys excited? Make some noise. Hey, all right. So my very first question that I want to know, and I think I might go to Cindy first, is, but I'm going to give it to all of you guys. So when it comes to science fiction, the genre, what do you enjoy most or find most alluring about it as either a performer or as a fan? Yeah. Why did you, it's not a test. Why did you get?
No, because I don't want to be the first one.
Okay, does anybody want to, does anybody offer themselves as tribute? No? Listen, don't let the pink fool you. It's nerd all day over here. Don't let these blazers that these people gave me to wear fool you. I will be nerding out. Anyways.
Okay.
So, I like it.
So when I was a little girl, I was obsessed with the Dark Crystal and the Labyrinth, like obsessed. And I lived more in a make-believe land of fairies and unicorns and dragons than human beings. So when I got to audition for the Henson Company for Ciera, I saw the logo of the Jim Henson Company on the audition, and I was like, oh my gosh, I have to get this, because like it's meant to be. It's in the stars, you know? So when I went for the audition, I created an alien, and it was really cool because, you know, we get to play doctors and nurses and lawyers and the, you know, the girl next door and whatever, but it's very rare that you can play a creature that we've never met before. So when I walked into the, I spoke to the director and I said, oh, how do you want me to show she's alien? Because Farscape hadn't yet been shown on Australian TV, so I hadn't seen it. And the guy goes, I just want to see if you can act. I was like, but that's all part of it. And I didn't know that there was the makeup. Ciera's makeup was 3.5 hours every day. How long was your makeup?
Wow. Mine was 5 hours
oh
on.
Oh my God.
2 hours to get off.
That's intense. That's
head to toe, though, yeah.
Woo!
It's like, oh, it's a lot. It's gross.
So I did all these like interesting little movements and stuff, but it wasn't until like there was like 8 rounds of auditions. They took me to the creature shop. They gave me like these weird fang teeth, but then I spoke with a lisp and I dribbled, so they got rid of them. Then there's so many different, like they put so much time and energy into inventing this creature, you know. And finally I looked in the mirror one day and I saw the character looking back at me. And she was just amazing. And that's something, you know, you get from the sci-fi world. That after that, I went to work on a show for about 6 months and I played, you know, the roommate, the girl next door, and the makeup was 40 minutes and I felt so unloved and so because I was so used to being, you know, constantly decorated. So I love that. I love sci-fi. I love going through the uncharted territories. They made the women on Farscape really strong. If there was a gun scene where the character comes in and, you know, is meant to shoot a gun, I'd say to the director, can I physically fight, because she's really scrappy and she's really crazy and that's part of her nature, how she survived the uncharted territories. And they're like, yeah, go for it. So they gave us a lot of artistic license as well. So I'm all about sci-fi. I'm a big geek. My daughter's name is Skywalker. First name Sky, middle name Walker. So the geekdom runs deep.
That's awesome. I love that.
I'd like to meet Sky Walker. Okay, so I feel like growing up, I was around in the 80s, you know, when like Alien came out and all these other, what I noticed about sci-fi films is there was always like one strong woman, kind of, and she was like a fighter pilot, or she was, you know, she was, you know, and I, as a young girl, I always attached myself to that character, which I'm sure a lot of people did, and that was always so fascinating to me, and I didn't think I was going to be an actor, but it definitely informed who I was as a girl growing up, and that I always admired those women, and I loved that. And I think I always saw myself as that kind of like heroine, like in the world, right? And I was very young when I got into acting, and then I just really gravitated to those kinds of characters. And I've just been lucky enough to be able to play those in a lot of different. Unfortunately, there's always like one woman, right? And I just felt really grateful that I was like, oh, I got the one woman on the team. And then, you know, sometimes I go in for an audition and I'd be reading for a man's role. They were all men. And then someone obviously in the writer's room or the production office was like, maybe we can have a woman or something. So like, you know, I felt like that was my niche for a while, was I was like the one chick in the movie. And I hope that starts to change a bit more, because I haven't actually seen that as far as my career has gone, because I think there's room for more of us. You know, you need one woman to carry 7 guys on like a SWAT team, you know. But like, that's what I always loved about sci-fi, actually. I mean, the aliens were cool and the stories were cool and the otherworldly stories, and you know, there's always like the good and the evil, and there's always these philosophical questions being answered, and that was all well and good, but I really was driven by that one character, especially because she was a woman, and that strength that they would always like sort of project with her, and that stuck with me forever. And now it's a massive part of my career, and I can't sort of deny how that kind of all came together. So more women in sci-fi, yes. more women in lead roles. Period. You know, it's all good.
Thank you both for that. It's amazing answers. I will definitely attest to, once you put on the costume, things go next level. Mm-hmm. And we're going to definitely expound on everything you just said, Jolene. So, but thank you for sharing that, because it's like, I think for all of us around the same time, it's always been like, oh, well, in sci-fi, can maybe like do a little something, something. Yeah. You know what I mean? There's a little more wiggle room there, especially if you're more masculine in your energy or your presentation or your artistry. Mm-hmm. So thank you. Yeah. Are you ready, Cindy?
Crystal,
yeah. Excuse me. It's okay. Sorry.
No worries. Crystal. I was like, Cindy's here?
Right. Well, Cindy not here, so.
I started off dancing. I was a dancer for many years. And I think that's how I fell into the Star Trek role, because I was an actor that dances, I guess. And they were looking for, you know, actors who could dance. And I just got it. And then I realized I was going to be green for 3 weeks in the makeup chair. But I, as far as sci-fi when I was a little girl, I mean, I did love Star Trek. I mean, I remember watching it. 60s and early 70s and Spock. I was a big fan of Spock. And it's really nice to, and we played the bad guys on the ship. I don't know if you've seen the episode Bound. Okay, you know. So we're innocent and we don't know anything about the electronics on the ship, and then we turn around and we're ruling the ship. So that was really fun. And then, yeah, it's really fun to play, like Jolene was saying, to play powerful women in a role. You know, it just, if it's makeup or it just gives you a powerful stance and you can be free with the role. You can, you know, be sarcastic and fun and funny. And I just love playing powerful women. And that goes along with other genres, too. It's just nice to see women now being leading roles in sci-fi. Really nice to see, right, guys? I mean, yeah. Come on. It's awesome.
Yes, absolutely. Chris, I just want to say, while you're talking, this person in the Star Trek attire is, like, totally in church. Oh. They're like, yes.
Yay, every time Star Trek. Like,
yeah.
Yeah. It's
period.
True.
Yeah.
And I love your costume. You look great.
I love it.
Thanks
so
for
awesome.
Coming.
I just wanted to acknowledge you. Yeah. Thank you for that, Janeshia.
Hi again. So, science fiction or sci-fi. What always interests me with sci-fi was the imagination and how far a person can go. I'm very big into people like fully committing to the thought. And so growing up, I was watching sci-fi, but didn't know I was watching it, right? Like, we all saw Back to the Future and stuff like that. Like, I remember watching it on a train ride to New York. But again, I didn't know what I was watching. It wasn't until I was like an adult till I realized, oh, this is science fiction. This is where they're playing with time travel and space. And I'm like, I'm here for it. Because someone had a thought and actually fully committed and didn't stop halfway, didn't break it up, didn't leave me confused. And it was probably like WALL-E. Like, I love WALL-E. I don't know if y'all know WALL-E. Hashtag 2008. Yeah, so I really liked WALL-E, and then fast forward things like Inception, like where they play with the time. I'm here for all of that. Mm. And so, yeah, so that's what I would say about science fiction or sci-fi. Just